I brought my album with me. My photo album. Well, yeah. I know what you're thinking. Oh no, she's gonna bore us with hundreds of pictures of perfect strangers and complicated explanations about who is who. This is Gérald when he was free. Look at his blonde curls. So cute. His mother had him very late. You know his mother, Gertrude. Gertrude. Gertrude, the sister of my cousin's wife. Gertrude, I showed her to you about 12 pages ago. You know, the one playing badminton on the beach in her pink Bermuda. Gertrude. You are not following. Pictures can be dreadful. Dreadful. That reminds me of a dinner 15 years ago. I had been in San Francisco for 2 months, and I was starting to realize that it was not going to be easy to find a boyfriend. All my new male friends were gay, and I was already not that young anymore. So when my friend Sylvie suggested that I should meet a friend of her husband, single and attractive, I took on the offer. He was German and worked with Paul in the Silicon Valley. They were both software engineers. Huh. An engineer that would change me from my previous series of losers. The guy invited Paul and Sylvie for dinner. They come to pick me up and drove me to the dinner. I got invited too. So they drove me to the dinner somewhere in the South Bay. I was all pampered. The guy opened the door. He was red and sweaty, quite bald with thin hair, barely covering his pink skull. Bad nose and a red bluish eyes and rather chubby, he made me think of a pig. Hello, on your own, welcome. Hi, Sabine, nice to meet you. Not at all the fancy, blonde, green-eyed German engineer I had in mind. Sylvie, ton ami.
Mais tu vas voir.
Okay, you have to give the product a chance. So there we are, sitting around a big oval table in a pretty small living room, scrammed. The room is square, modern, boring. Only decoration, a shelf with some books and knickknacks. The food is pretty average. Spaghetti with tomato sauce and meatballs. Dry parmesan cheese in a carton shaker. It's good, we brought a big salad. Johan is eating avidly. Yes, tomato sauce on his right cheek. So, where are you from? Paris, Paris. I've spent 20 years in Paris, but before that... Oh, Paris, I love Paris. La Tour Eiffel, le Champs-Élysées, le Sacré-Cœur. I have visited everything. I was there 3 years ago with my girlfriend at the time. That's classic. Every time I mention Paris, anybody, everybody has a memory, an anecdote, and I don't get to speak anymore. They stayed in an hotel near La Gare Montparnasse, the best bus term. Ah, the hotels, I only trust Americans. Very fast, he stops paying attention to me. Thank God. The conversation rolls on one of the favorite topics of expatriates. Marvels and delights of the country we left behind. Flows of our country of adoption. Paul and Sylvie started with food. Look at the yogurt section in Safeway. What a misery. Everything is sweet and gelatinous. When I remember the crèmerie in Carrefour. 5 grams of crème fraîche. 5. Les yaourts nature Danone. Danone with the E at the end. Yoplait, Maminova. Le fromage blanc. La faisselle. Le Gervita. Les crèmes brûlées. Les crèmes caramel. Les rillances. Les liégeois au chocolat. Les pains suisses. Les petits suisses. Les pains au chocolat. I'm gonna find a good sauerkraut. And what about the price? What a rip-off! 11 bucks for a camembert, not even ripe. They don't know how to serve draft beer. And me, I dream of a sandwich, rillettes cornichon. Then, the conversation continues on annoyances, like having to calculate service at the end of every meal in restaurants, or being jumped on by waiters when you are, yes, still working on it, not hard enough maybe. And then in bars, being able to drink inside, but not smoke, and smoke outside, but not drink. Therefore separating those two activities that go so well together. So, Johan is not the dream date. But the evening is fun, at least I can relate. Now we are talking about ants. Johan has ants in his kitchen. Not in the tomato sauce, I hope. And Paul and Sylvie are giving him advice about how to get rid of ants. Everything has to be super clean. Not a crumb, not a speck of sugar. Yes, with Paul, every weekend, we take all the furniture out on the terrace. And then we vacuum all the carpets and we wipe all the floors and we clean all the windows and we scrub every time in the kitchen and every time in the bathroom. And then we disinfect every corner with Javel water. And before we bring back the furniture, we brush the couch and we brush the armchairs, and we swipe the shelves and wax the tables. That's what we do. And Paul, we want our house impeccable. Yeah, we don't have any ants. Bad for me. I didn't know that Paul and Sylvie were such neat freaks. I'm gonna spend the night at their place. I'm gonna be cautious with my crumbs at breakfast. Yeah, but Johan, the most to mop the floor after each meal. Yeah, but then you have to find a good mop. The American mops are very lousy. No, it's true. Look all the stuff here. Look at the washing machine. The water is tepid. And the clothes, they just sit there, blip, 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 swimming in the dirt. Ah, oh, the German washing machine, the wash. I always do a last hand wash. I don't. Suddenly, Johan switch off the... suddenly, Johan pulls a screen on the wall and switch off the lights. I am gonna show you my pictures from Thailand. I was there last summer on an organized tour. It's good. You don't waste time looking for hotels or monuments. You get bogus on the pictures. And there we are, in the dark, all conversations shut down. Johan is behind us by the projector, an old style projector with slides. Landscapes taken from the bus window. Plenty of landscapes. Really flat, actually. Farmers bent on their fields in the farm. Tons of bags in the market. The group, the bus, the group. And then a series of flowers taken from very close. The guy is obsessed with flowers. Once in a while, Johan stopped the projector to make a comment. Oh yeah, that is the village where I bought my little ivory elephant. I had to bargain a lot with an old woman. She was tough. But I got it half price. Yeah, he surely said $2 or $3. With pay in the village. Temples. The bus, the group, flowers, an elephant, butterfly. There are hundreds of slides. I feel trapped. And then Johan in swimsuit with palms and snorkeling equipment. Ah, that was when I was in Phuket. I was snorkeling. I really regret I didn't have an underwater camera. There could be a lot of fish pictures tonight. God forbid! The sunset on the sea, taken every minute so that we don't miss one beat. Extraordinary event. The bottle next to me is empty. I reach for the wine is strong and heavy like port, but I'm so bored, anything will do. And then a giant statue of Buddha erected in nature. Many, many pictures of this Buddha statue. At one point, two Buddhas. Buddhas are smiling at me with compassion. Really soon, I can't really, I'm not able to watch the slides anymore. And then, suddenly, there must be a bouquet final. Paul and Sylvie clap their hands. And the light comes back. I stumble in the shelf. Some knickknacks fall. As it turns out, the little ivory elephant is part of the accident. I'm never going to be invited again. Paul and Sylvie drag me in their car and throw me on their couch with a blanket. I am so drunk. In the middle of the night, I wake up with a terrible headache and no memory at all. Just a urge to pee. So I think I'm in my home in San Francisco, and I take what I think is the way to my bathroom. Bah, wow. I hit a very hard surface. I'm very hurt. Warm, dripping along my face. Oh, but I still have to go to the bathroom. And I have to find the way in the dark. Finally, I find the bathroom. I pee, wrap my head in a towel, and comes back on the couch in a semi-coma. In the morning, Paul wakes up to go to the kitchen, get a drink of water. Sylvie, Sylvie, viens voir. I think Sabine has had some women problems. Blood everywhere. There is blood on the walls. There is blood on the curtains. There is a puddle of blood at the entrance of the kitchen. There is blood on the white carpet and the couch. Everywhere my hands have touched are tracks. Like a serial killer. A platform whose ritual kill. Dexter. I fly to the bathroom. I see myself. Oh, I have a black eye, cuts on my chin and my cheeks. A very big bruise on my arm. Paul has already cleaned the blood at the kitchen and is wiping all he can the walls and the windows. I offer to pay for cleaning and pen job, but he's not even looking at me. He's very pale. Sylvie, very helpful, put band-aids on my cuts and an ice pack on my arm and. Yeah. Suddenly, I sneeze. My eye the size of a tennis ball. À l'hôpital. So, Sylvie takes me to a suburban Kaiser. And there we are in the waiting room. Elephant Man. And Sylvie reading a magazine. Hey Sabine, you're a Sagittarius, right? This is gonna cheer you up. It's your horoscope. 2 days planet, today's planet brings a popularity spike and expand your radius, your social circle. Take every opportunity. Sagittarius, you are charming. And the people you meet will perk your interest like you are going to perk their interest. Right. Finally, a nurse calls me to take my blood pressure. Well, he's got big fist, the guy. No, 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 it's not a guy, it's a wall. I hit the wall. Yeah. He's got big fist, the wall. No, 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 I'm telling you, he hits the wall. Yeah. Honey, I know what I see. Eventually, a doctor comes to see me, a woman. Black eye, cuts, bruise, what happened? It was at night, I was in my home, but I wasn't in my home, so in the dark, I hit the wall and... Are you sure you've not been hit by somebody? Do you feel safe at home? No, I'm telling you, I mean, it's a wall, I hurt myself on the wall. Yes, I just want to make sure, are you sure you're not protecting somebody that you shouldn't protect? No, really, it was an accident. Mrs. Delarue, by law, I have to ask you 3 times. Mrs. Delarue, have you been a victim of domestic violence? Mrs. Delarue, have you been a victim of domestic violence? Mrs. Delarue, have you been a victim of domestic violence? No, no, no. It was the wall. It was the wine. It was the slides. It was the lousy place. It was the awful dinner. It was the loneliness. It was the boredom. How can I be a victim of domestic violence? I don't even have a boyfriend. Never invited me again for a sleepover. And I am not gonna show you my pictures. Way too dangerous.